thank God for yet another Sabbath. I am very happy to be here. I am a historian. I did history and philosophy for my bachelor's. And so the name Jomo Kenyatta is not alien to me. And so when the invitation came, I had an appointment elsewhere today, but I have to talk it over. And then God did something, and that invitation was actually squashed so that I can make way for Jomo Kenyatta. And as a matter of fact, today is going to be my last Sabbath here in Kenya. On Wednesday, I'll be flying to Ghana. And so I'm very happy to meet you and to speak with you. If that is clear, say amen. Amen. I bring you special greetings from my wife, who had wanted to be here with me today. Currently, she is in Kasarani, babysitting. And so can't be here. And so she sends her regards. And I hope you do respond to that. Great. Once again, I bring you special greetings from Ghana, West Africa. As you may well know, Ghana is a country in West Africa. I want to believe that you know that. I am doing all of this simply to prove a point. And my point is this. Whenever I mount the pulpit, I recognize I have an accent. But I am always quick to say that we all have accents. You have your accent, I have my accent. And so, just as I started speaking, I want to believe that someone is sitting down. What is this? I am speaking the African accent. And I want to believe that you flow with me. By extension, I am speaking the East African accent, whether I like it or not, even though arguable. And so I want to believe that you are getting me. And so this is one of the things I do just to warm you up. And so by the time I get the most important message, now you are a Ghanaian. And so that is that. So special greetings from Ghana, West Africa. We have 10 regions in Ghana. You have about 47 counties, right? 47. We have 10 regions. We call it regions, you call it counties. We have 10 of such and a population of about 25 million. You can tell that Ghana, we are not even too many. You are far, far, and the Kenyans, you live there a lot. Invite you specially for this afternoon service. prepare you, most especially the Seventh-day Adventist, for a work, a divine work, which we have neglected. You see, I entered the elder when we entered, I was like, wow, this is a prepared place for some mission work to be done. And so this afternoon, I'm inviting all of you to come, and then we will share this particular presentation. I will tell you what is happening around the world. And then in the first verse, I will share just a little. You know, this is going to be a brief something because I didn't have the time to go through. I was told that here in Kenya, and I think I've been in Kenya for the past 2 months and some few weeks, and I have been moving around so many churches. Some of you may have even seen me on Book Channel. And the sermon I preach there is the same sermon I'll be preaching today. And so if you listen to that, you'll listen to it twice. And I've been going around and I came to the conclusion that this particular, you know, issue is a very serious issue here in Kenya. In Ghana, we had our own problem, you know, students asking so many questions on the Trinity. And I wish that at least we can use a brief minute, probably 20 or 35 minutes, just to touch on this. I will tell you what I also have, or what the Bible says, based on our research on the Trinity and the Bible and Adventism. I'll be speaking on it briefly, and that will be our verses. That will be our verses. Something is going on around the world, and it is time for us to wake up to the call and do our bit as students and as Seventh-day Adventists before the second coming of our Lord and Master Savior. As a matter of fact, campus ministry is growing, and God is prospering His work. And that is the major reason why I want you to be part of this afternoon's presentation. In Ghana, these are the men who are behind public campus ministry. You can see me just there, very tiny. Yeah. And then you can see this, our director, the director for the Southern Ghana Union. Ghana has two unions as far as the Seventh-day Adventist Church is concerned. We have the Southern Union, and then we have the Northern Union. The Southern Union is where we have the capital city of Ghana, Accra. And I am coming from the eastern part of Ghana. And it is just about 2 hours drive from the city, Accra, to the eastern part of Ghana. And so that is our director for the Southern Ghana Union, the director in charge of public campus ministry and chaplains. And this was one of our meetings. And all the pastors you see there, these are the men behind public campus ministry in Ghana. And the Lord is doing a great job there as far as student missionary work is concerned. Even though we have our own issues, but the Lord is still prospering us. We normally run trainings for students, and you can see me running a training for Adventist students in one of our polytechnics, that is a technical university within my conference. We train them, and then we actually empower them for a mission work on campus. And I think we can do the same here. We hold various kinds of programs, like a choral festival. We sing. You know, Adventists are known by our good quality music. And so we use the music to propagate the three angels' message. And in Ghana, we are doing that. These are schools, these are students, and they have devoted part of their time to minister unto others through music. And music is doing a lot. It is doing a lot, winning a lot of souls as far as the church is concerned. We normally gather somewhere for a retreat, and we have a nice time. We also do have what we call Bible lecture series. Bible lecture series, in which we normally do it on campuses, public campuses. This one was done at the Oforidia Technical University within my conference, where I was a speaker, and at the end, a lot of people were baptized to the glory of God. Say amen to that. I think we can do the same here. I'm simply saying this, I'm giving you a background to what I'll be speaking about in the afternoon. And so the Lord is doing marvelous things. This was during the week of spiritual emphasis, which is technically known as Bible Lecture Series. At the end, these candidates were baptized. They were baptized to the glory of God. The young lady you see in the row, this young lady is a Muslim, and she's ready. ready for baptism on a public campus university. We can do same here in Jomo Kenyatta. Say amen to that. And at the end, that is the candidates. We have a nice time. We don't have a baptismal, you know, a baptistry, a prepared baptistry. So we normally do it in the river. And that is where you can see a very neat river, probably River Jordan. As that, these are the candidates ready for baptism, ready for baptism. And it is a joyful thing. Very joyful. When students are able to, as it were, bring their own students back into God's fold, it is a joyful thing. You can see them very happy. And the pastor baptized them. We do have so many programs, and just this last year we had a 500 year celebration of Protestant Reformation. I want to believe that you remember. I don't know if you celebrated. For us, we celebrated in Ghana, and we did it in the form of a public campus missionary wedding. And so in one of the schools, the Sunday Adventist schools, I organized a program, and it was a lecture series. It was done on Friday and on the Sabbath. And there you can see me speaking on the theme, the Reformation. The historical antecedent of the Reformation and the effect that the Reformation has had on our Christianity today and where we are headed towards. The room was packed to the extent that students cannot even have a place to sit. That is what you can see. The room was full, packed, and everyone attentively listened to the lecture. I invited people coming from other faiths. A Roman Catholic priest was there, and a Presbyterian priest was there. This man you can see here is a Presbyterian priest and a police officer. In fact, he is a chaplain of the police service within my area of catchment. He is not an Adventist. I invited him. And then I invited a Muslim, you know, also to tell us their view on the Protestant Reformation. And the Almighty Catholics were also there. And the rest are Seventh-day Adventist pastors, and that is me. And that is the principal of the Seventh-day Adventist College, teacher training college in my area. And that is our executive secretary of the conference. This is the headmistress of a senior high school there. And then this is also a pastor. And so we invited all of these people, and this was my aim. I wanted them to know our stand. We wanted them to know what the Seventh-day Adventist, our outlook on the Protestant Reformation. But we can never, you know, just invite them to come and sit down and just listen. I gave them the pulpit to also tell us their perspective, what they view the Protestant Reformation to be. And it was a nice program. And this is what I think we should be doing as far as campus ministry is concerned. Bringing those people on board and using our pulpit just to tell them and strengthen their record so that one day we can have them. You see, these are called the little things. There is no means that this man one day can become a Seventh-day Adventist because he was taught and he testified to it. There is no need that this man here, the Muslim, can become a Seventh-day Adventist one day. Why? Because they were taught. And this is what I was speaking about in the afternoon. I just want to whet your appetite, and I'm inviting everyone here to be part